Well, good evening. Thanks for being here tonight. It's been now 2.5 months since our endorsing convention in May, and a great call. Even if maybe you supported somebody else, I'm very grateful for the support since May 19th. We have been working really, really hard on a daily basis, not a weekly, not a monthly, but on a daily basis, hour to hour, on this race. And it goes, I usually talk about it as 1A, 1B, and 1C, which is door knocking, which we're out 5 to 6 days a week. So hopefully either you've seen the literature or we've been in your neighborhood. Well, we're doing everything we can to get out and be face-to-face with voters. We're coalition building. We're trying to get all the spheres of influence that we can to support the campaign. And then we're raising money. And I'm happy to say, because of a lot of effort and a lot of hard work and a lot of you that have supported the campaign, that we had the top fundraising effort for a candidate in the whole state senate and basically the house. So we did very well in the first quarter. And but it comes down to, as we've talked about in the past, this is all about hard work. This is all about shoe leather. Nobody knows that better than Sarah Anderson. Nobody knows that better than Jeff Johnson. Patty is out there just the same. We are working as a team, and we're working hard because this is an opportunity. This state senate seat was listed of all places in MinnPost last week. If anybody follows MinnPost, it's not necessarily friendly to us Republicans, but it's listed as a top 10 Senate race in the state. And we've known that. We've known, actually, it's probably a top 5, if not top 3. You can ask Senator Osmick on his opinion on that. But this is really critical. If the Senate has a chance at flipping to Republican and majority, this Senate district has to flip. And we will. I really, really believe that this is an awesome, awesome chance, but it's going to take a lot of hard work. It's going to take a lot of volunteer effort. So I can't do it alone. A lot of you have already come out and helped. I'm really grateful for the help we've got. We've now got 96 days to go. What we're hearing at the doors, they're not crazy about a special session. I don't think anybody here is crazy about a special session. They're not crazy about the train. They're not crazy about the spending that's going on in this state. We're not crazy about a lot of things that Dayton is doing. A lot of people are ready for Dayton to leave, but we got 2 years. If we flip the Senate, we take majority, and Senator Osmick gets a gavel, and we've got other leadership, we've got an opportunity to play stopgap for 2 years before the election. So I'm grateful for the opportunity to be here. And I hope I get a chance to talk to as many of you as I can tonight. But just know the effort, the attitude, everything is positive. This is a positive campaign because, again, this is the first time in 11 years we have a chance now. We had some awesome candidates and put in a lot of effort, but this opportunity, with the setting and everything going on, we're going to win this. But I need your help, so thank you very much.